National Instruments is going full steam ahead with its expansion plans in Asia. The technology pioneer recently opened an office in Vietnam and is expecting sales growth in the region, Asia, to continue to outpace that of the Western world. Let's talk to Alex DeVerne. He is CFO, COO, also Executive Vice President of National Instruments. He joins us around the desk here at the SGX in a first on CNBC interview and a CNBC exclusive as well. Alex, great to see you and welcome to this part of the world. Pretty balanced or even growth. The U.S. 23, Q1, this is in terms of percentage gain. Europe 23, Asia though 29, this is where the future sounds like.
Yeah, certainly Asia is a huge future for us. We've had the fastest growth in this region for the last decade. Our revenues are up fivefold in the last 10 years. Fundamentally, we sell to scientists and engineers, and the greatest growth in the number of scientists and engineers is coming in the Asia region, and we certainly want to tap into that opportunity.
What about CapEx and tech spend? I mean, do you get a sense that it's a lot stronger out here?
Yeah, certainly, you know, our customers, as I said, are scientists and engineers, and when we go where they go. We use our products to promote their productivity, drive down cost, and so within the engineering community, as they scale up in the Asia-Pacific region, we see a broad-based opportunity across a multitude of industries for us, from alternative energy, production, manufacturing test, all the way up to high-end physics applications in the Asia-Pacific region.
Wow. How big or important a market is China? Because we talk about the place minting millionaires, but they also mint PhDs and in research scientists.
Yes, and that's really our market opportunity. So we're focused on productivity gains for scientists and engineers. China has been a huge growth market for National Instruments. Over the last 5-7 years, it has outpaced the growth of any other region in the world for us, and we certainly expect that as Asia as a region grows to be the largest revenue producer for National Instruments globally, China will be a key feature of that.
Mm. Alex,
the engineering talent there is really phenomenal.
Indeed. I'm curious to know your perspective on the logistics side of the operation, and in particular, what lessons were learned from the supply chain disruptions from the natural disasters in Japan, March the 11th.
Yeah, certainly that exposes the fallacy a little bit of just-in-time. We're a very high gross margin business. Our margins average around 78%. So for us, supply assurance is absolutely crucial. Not being able to deliver to our customers is a very expensive proposition, not only disrupting our customers, but also disrupting our own financial performance. And for that reason, we keep pretty deep inventories. Our engineering customers rely very heavily on the availability of our products. And because we keep 6-9 months of inventory available, we're able to come through the disruptions in Japan, the terrible events there, without any impact to our customers at all so far. Okay. And we don't anticipate that it'll have any impact as we go forward.
Yeah, you talked about the nuclear industry. You talked about manufacturing as well as part of your business. You know, one of the next big things in manufacturing is something called additive manufacturing, as opposed to, you know, I don't know what you call it, deletive manufacturing, where you do the milling and machining, etc. I mean, are you gearing up for that as well?
Well, what we do is we provide software? Productivity tools. So we enable our customers to switch from vendor-defined module or vendor-defined instrumentation, which really makes the engineer into an operator. We allow them to switch to user-defined modular instrumentation built on our hardware, our application software, and then the PC platform. That allows the engineer to move from being an operator to being an innovator. And so our whole message and ability of our business is to bring our engineering customers up the value chain. And we see this really clearly in countries like China and Malaysia and throughout the Southeast Asian region, where there's a desperate hunger for moving up the value chain to improve the standard of living. And we want to be able to enable that by allowing engineers and scientists around the world to deliver a lot more value to their businesses, to be innovators. And that's really our message.
And in the process, empower engineers as well, sounds like, huh?
Absolutely.
Okay, listen, Alex, we got to go. Great to talk to you. Thanks for dropping by.
See you very
soon.
Bye-bye.
Okay, Alex DeVerne, CFO, COO, also Executive VP at National Instruments, around the desk here with us at the SGX.